And he is the number 16 seed, the last guy in this round.
And over on the LOP, Samele is up 4-3 over O.
And Dershowitz here on the red page of the United States up 6-1 against Anstead of France. And Samele at 5-3 ahead of O.
So, Peter, basically everything Abedini tried there didn't work. Basically everything Satmari did worked.
Yeah. But he's got that rotation of tactics, though.
Right.
Attack, a counterattack, para riposte. I think if he just continues not letting Abedini be able to predict, he's gonna cruise home.
And it's attack and preparation by Satmari, and that's the grand slam. We have the remise, the riposte, the attack, and the attack and preparation.
I just think Abedini's a deer in the headlights at this point. Oh, there's a nice attack by him. I think he's trying to gather himself back. There goes Abedini. Coming back into focus. A pair of post, but a pair of post missed. Satmari hits on the attack. So we've seen before that this means attack. And all the way, Satmari trying to move aside and not get hit, avoid the touch, which if Abedini hits, it's his.
There's a simultaneous in the middle. I'm looking for a parry riposte by Satmari in this action. Tried attack in preparation.
Did he get it?
Come on, ref, come on. It wasn't that mine?
Looking at the replay. Could be. Meanwhile, on the red piece, Dershowitz at the break, up 8-5 over Anstead of France.
Referee calls simultaneous. Same action as the previous one. Looks like Satmar is a little quicker, but if they both start at the same time, it's still simultaneous. Satmar with a long, quick attack, and Abedini retreated just enough at a distance to make Satmar fall short, and he scored on the counterattack.
He's really woken up. He's definitely pulled himself together.
So Sunmar has been hit now twice on his own attack. I don't see him doing that three times in a row.
But he did. And he got it.
And he got it. And that's why I'm here and he's there.
That's the truth. Meanwhile, Mr. O has pulled ahead of Samele, 7-6 on the hello beast.
Satmari acknowledges the attack from Abedini.
Well, he only got a four-touch differential. That's pretty good. Nope, there's that long attack again.
Nice attack by Abedini. Brings it to 7-12. It looked like Satmari just wasn't prepared for that. Pushing, Abedini's pushing.
Oh, and usually that getting back down to the end means disaster, but this time Satmari makes that beautiful para riposte at the end.
And you know, some fencers are actually more comfortable when they're pushed to the end because they're waiting for that para riposte.
They both stop, they both start, but there's only one light. Abedini scores it.
Abedini's attack is short or it missed. Satmari's counterattack is what scores.
Takes over, as they say. Meanwhile, Mr. O ahead of Samele, 8-6. He's really come ahead.
Fire!
Satmari. Victory and moves on to the eight. I thought Abedini did a good job to come back.
It was a nice comeback for sure.
And Samele holding his own against Mr. O on the yellow strip. He's got it to be 7-8, and O is still trying to continue his great run. That hand going up, I think, meant halt. It didn't mean a touch to the left.
No touch, referee says, simultaneous.
Attack pair or post.
O was waiting for that. He pulled distance and was waiting for Samale's attack. Made the riposte.
Staying ahead. He went into the break behind, did O.
And asked for the replay, does O.
Meanwhile, on the red strip, Dershowitz of the United States ahead 12-6 over Anstett of France.
Referee takes away the last touch. O's protest is upheld. It's challenged.
He's still got his two touch lead. Something is short, but now O takes over. He did that closeout we saw earlier in the women's event with a lefty righty, and he closed him out.
It's pretty risky.
Yeah.
Because O was looking for the para riposte and.
And pulled an Arrigo.
Yeah.
And look, he's Italian. O's long attack does hit this time.
Right, he said, I had enough of these little closeouts. This is, now it's time for me to attack. Now, Samuel got pretty steamrolled on that one. I don't see him retreating off the line on this action.
So O's ahead. Mr. O's ahead on the attack.
Wow, he is fast.
And long.
Right. All the fences are fast. Some of them just a touch quicker.
Yep.
Explosive footwork in the saber fencing. Samuel not happy with that call. But it's time for him to refocus on the next action.
You can't have a long memory in this sport. You
nope.
Got to get over it and go forward.
And there's a yellow card for O for jumping the call of Allais or start or go.
Pair of riposte. Long attack by O, and Samele looking for it. Oh, there's those strips again, and someone else stumbles. See that all weekend.
I think the fences are just moving too fast, Peter. I don't think it's the strips.
Really? Okay. They're flying over the strip. Their feet never touch the ground, right, Jeff?
The saber footwork is simply incredible.
It is.
So fast. Para riposte by Samuele. O went for the attack, and Samuele was waiting with a para riposte. And he scored two riposte of his last three actions now. That's working for him.
I was going to say that the footwork was so fast, it outran the work of the cameraman because it went right out of the screen.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, on the red strip, Dershowitz of the United States ahead 14-7 against Anstett of France. He's hit it with a stop hit.
He's feeling the distance right now, is Samuele.
Really perfect distance.
Yeah, on the defense, perfect. With the riposte, with the stop hit. Let's see if the fencers get out of the box right there in the middle, the four-meter spot between the two on guard lines.
11-0, uh-oh.
That could be a red card.
He wants it. Delilah is appealing. She's the referee both started. It looked like to me by her body language.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Dershowitz closes out the victory against Unstetter France.
What a riposte by Samele there. His defense right now is winning this bout. Unbelievable.
It is.
Just came with the most explosive attack down the piece, and Samele retreated at a distance and just made a beautiful head parry and a riposte.
To go ahead. He was behind by 3 touches. Look what's happened.
Great fencing by Samele.
I'm surprised O's still attacking. Distance. Look at that. Oh.
Samele was short. He reprised and he was short again. And O took over the attack and made the new attack. It's not a riposte. The attack is short, and technically O makes a new attack and scores.
He was all the way at the end and profited from it. Tie score at 12. That's an unusual and skillful and risky action.
Sort of interesting that Samele, after all the success in defense, went for the explosive attack and it backfired on him.
So that's kind of O's move. He makes his attack and then goes to one knee and appeals to the ref.
Is it appealing or praying?
On the knee?
The referee says, attack by O.
He got it. I don't think similar will happen.
He probably does have some skinned knees at the end of the event because he does seem to go down in that position. Okay, so this time O scored on the attack. He didn't get parried and riposted, so now he maybe feels comfortable again on the attack. Let's see if he tries again.
And back to the video replay.
Referee says
simultaneous. Simile discipline. That long attack, it fell short. Simile
very successful
takes advantage
with that action.
Perfect distance. He's been great on defense. Oh, and now he definitely wants a red card. Is he going to get it?
Again, the key here is you don't want one fencer gaining an advantage over the other. That's the whole purpose of refereeing, is to maintain a level playing field.
But here the Italian is appealing. Please give that card. Let me hit a touch off of it.
Quick breather by Samuel. Clear the sweat out of the eyes. Plan the next action.
Stop, start. Who's ahead?
Referee simultaneous.
They both are convinced they got the attack there. They went as fast as they could.
So it's a referee says touch for O. You knew someone was going to be very unhappy on that call.
O went to one knee. What can I say? Now he wants to talk. It's both referees.
Referee Attar Cohen of Argentina saying this is what I saw. And gives the touch to Samele. And O says, that should have been mine. Okay, so
I
just like that.
She indicated the other way.
Me too.
Well, it was very close. Who was first? Was it stop-start, simultaneous? Or
well,
did someone get the advantage?
If the call was based on how a fencer reacted, that touch would be Samuel's because he was
one
yelling.
Touch away,
O was quiet, but the referee's going to say no touch. Two simultaneous in a row. Is someone going to take a risk here and go for a parry?
Yeah.
And the answer is yes, Samuele took the risk.
But lost.
And lost. And but I respect the fact that he tried that, because after two simultaneous in a row, you, at some point you have to make a move.
Okay, 14-0. The longest and last bout remaining of this round.
Neither fencer wants to go back on the defense here and take a retreat.
You predict simultaneous?
I would say on the first one, they're going to stay in the box. They're right in the middle. So it's probably be simultaneous.
They're both celebrating. He's got the one knee going on.
Referee Ata Cohen going to check with the video referee Marius Florea. Very experienced four-time Olympic referee.
Cohen, go back to your line.
Go back to the line.
Mm-hmm. And O wins.
And the winner is O.
He's had a great run today. Strip here we have Mr. Goop, number one seed from Korea, against the long Ukrainian Yadgotka. And our featured bout here, Kuratoli and Wagner. They both settle in. Another lefty-righty matchup. Stop start.
Simultaneous. Referee Florea, Romania.
Wagner reaches his taller fencer.
And he likes to take the blade. A lot of his actions are on the blade.
Stops the attack and then goes for the counter action.
Nice attack. He's got a reach advantage. Very tall, very long arms. Using that reach to his advantage there. That's two very simple attacks.
So long.
Very long. Kuratoli's going to have to prevent Wagner from pushing him like that. Maybe not retreat as quickly. Like that.
Yeah. Meanwhile, here on the red piece, Yagutka is ahead 4-1 against the number one seed, Gu of Korea.
Power post by Kuratoli. Wow. So now the last two touches without retreating. He says, I can't keep going back because he was getting hit too easily. So he's changed his tactics effectively.
I did it again. Good call. 3-0. There, he ties it up. Don't go back.
Kuratoli went for the attack.
Wagner's too tall.
He's tall, pulled the distance and hit in the counterattack. But give Kuratoli credit. He changed his tactics. It's been very effective since the first three touches.
He stopped and started, and Wagner started. See what they call. Kuratoli stopped and went before Wagner got going.
Kuratoli has not taken one step back off the on-guard line since he was hit on that third touch.
Thank you. I don't want the replay.
So right now, if you're in the middle in the box like that, Wagner's distance advantage is negated. It's almost like he has to...
you don't go back.
Right, you have to open up the distance a little bit to use that reach advantage. Right. Referee says simultaneous.
Oh, big long attack.
And that's the first time Curatoli has retreated even one step and he got hit.
Yep.
So he's learned his lesson for the most part, but he can't keep ceding ground like that against the longer fencer.
You're right, he went forward. Trying to disrupt him with a line, taking a blade, runs away with distance, takes over the attack.
Wagner there with the point in line, saying take it away or you're going to get hit. And actually, Wagner took the point in line away by himself. And when you have the point in line and you pull it back like that, that gives the right away to your opponent.
Absolutely. And we've already seen way back at the other end, the percentage is very high. You're going to get hit. Stop, start. Who was first? Nobody.
There's noise in the room. So sometimes the fencer looks like one's jumping the gun, but there's a lot of noise going on. So the referees are giving a little leeway there.
Meanwhile, on the red strip, after being behind by as many as three touches, Gu of Korea has pulled ahead 8-6 of Yagodka of the Ukraine. Number one seed that has a lead at the break.
And Kuratoli there with just an explosive beat attack.
Lead to 7-5. That one looks simultaneous to me. Oh, pair of repos. That time he didn't go back, right? That was interesting.
Yes.
Oh. Then we go to the break with Kuratoli ahead. 8-5 with that long explosive attack to the head.
Very quick. The first step was very quick.
Yeah.
And beat Wagner to the punch.
Against Huber's leading 10-6 against the guy that upset a couple of our fencers. Huber's having a good day today, but now he's down 10-6. He's the one that put out Daryl Homer.
Daryl Homer, the Rio Olympic silver medalist.
I thought that was an upset. I think most people do. But Hoover's, that's a great bout. I watched it. And Wagner goes and scores on an attack. Here we go, simultaneous. Back to the yellow piece. Notice how Curatoli's feet are just not lined up.
Yep.
A little weird to me. Yeah, he makes a nice long attack, though. Obviously, it's effective.
Yep. He is somewhat of an unconventional on guard there with the back foot behind the front foot.
Yeah. He started first, and Wagner wants a warning. I didn't see a card come up.
No.
Stop, start.
Wagner started with short. Curatoli countered with short, and then they both went together, says the referee.
Attack. Curatoli a little faster.
He's not retreating off the on guard line. It seems to be a tactic here. Wow.
That was a long attack again. It looked like he froze him in his tracks.
Explosive, really, very quick.
It looked like Wagner couldn't do it. He just stood there. Oh, he wants that warning now. See, he wants a warning. Then what happens?
And that's a yellow card. Again, the referees will allow the fencer to do that once and jump the gun. The second time will outcome the yellow card. Now that was a beauty by Wagner there. He made a second or a low line parry and the riposte.
With a jump in the air.
Yeah, just waiting for that.
Oh, there's that long attack again to the head.
Yep.
Kuratoli, even though he's the more diminutive fencer, is really fast and explosive to the head. Simultaneous.
Would you? I think the difference in this bout so far has been the foot speed of Kuratoli.
Yeah. Despite his unconventional on guard. Another simultaneous.
Kuratoli's body cord came unplugged from his weapon, necessitating the referee to call halt.
That should be on the fencer. I mean, he's supposed to have a system that keeps the plug in place. It's part of the rules. But no penalty for it. And parry riposte against that long attack by Wagner. Kuratoli waiting for it, makes a parry riposte.
He looks very frustrated right now, this Wagner.
By the way, Kuratoli went backwards on that one.
And he got it.
That was Wagner's, yeah.
Kuratoli acknowledged it. Got hit in my preparation.
They call it simultaneous. Oh, short, and pair repose doesn't work, and Kuratoli scores.
And Wagner's body language is telling me that he's not feeling so good right
it's
now.
It's over.
Yeah.
Meanwhile,
beautiful
Dew wins
attack.
15-10 over the Ukrainian. And Kuratoli brings it home, 15-10 over Wagner of Germany. Our two high seeds here, Gu and Kuratoli, numbers 1 and 4. Is that right? No, 2 and 4. Move on. Well, all the bouts are over. And we now have a mandatory break while we total things up. And we're going to the round of 8. So, ladies and gentlemen, there has to be several decisions on who's refereeing what bout. And there's a mandatory rest period. So we're going to make our assessment and get ready for the next round. So until then, Peter Richard of the FIE Channel, along with Jeff Buchanz. We'll be right back. And ladies and gentlemen, we're back here in Cancun for the final eight of the men's Sabre competition at the Grand Prix 2017. Peter Burchard of the FIE Fencing Channel along with Jeff Buchanz. And I think, Jeff, we can look at our field and see that Korea is certainly a strong nation with three of the top eight. We have an American, we have a Frenchman, and two Hungarians.
And one of those Hungarians, is Aaron Szilagyi, who is the two-time Olympic gold medalist. And we have the top four seeds who have made the final eight here, Peter. And Satmari, Gu, Kim, and Kuratoli.
There you go. Well, it shows that the seeding has a purpose. Now, I think Oh, who won the last competition, is one to watch. But the Gu, number one in the world, fencing the young American, is the bout that seems very, very interesting.
And also the 1-8 bout between Satmari of Hungary and Apathy of France. It shouldn't go unknown that both of them have, this is their third consecutive World Cup final in this young season. This, of course, being a Grand Prix, so there's double points.
Double points, yeah.
So there's quite a lot of consistency there.
And O also, right? Pretty consistent.
Very consistent. So Satmari took fifth place in each of the first two World Cups. Apathy took seventh and third. So they're off to a very good start in this fencing season.
And Apathy, he defeated his teammate Sates, and Sates had defeated another Frenchman. So the roll of the dice put all the French against each other.
Happens that way. And Dershowitz, having won the first World Cup of the season, his second in his career, and finished ninth in the last World Cup, is also off to a really great start. So, and having beaten Montano, he probably overcame his idol. It's always one of the toughest things to do when you're a young fencer. I mean, he's really not that young. He's been fencing for a long time. But, you know, when you beat your idol, that's certainly a rite of passage for a fencer.
It is this evening, keep it going against number one in the world, Bon Gil Gu of Korea. So I think there's going to be a formal presentation of the finalists in just a few minutes. We were told that who's coming up, and I think they're all behind the curtain, so we can anticipate the parade in just a few minutes.
And, you know, there's a tremendous cadre of referees here in Cancun, but it should be known that the four referees that were selected here for the table of eight are certainly the most experienced in Florey of Romania, Malenche of Bulgaria, Martellotti of Italy, and Kosha of Hungary.
And look at those countries. Yeah, my goodness. They are saber powers. And here comes the theme music. The fencers proceed to their strips. I think it's remarkable that the Koreans have three of the top eight. Kim eliminated the last Hungarian. He's got Szilagyi now. So that's a big story. Oh, winner of previous World Cup. That's a big story. And Gu, number one in the world.
And listen, in the last World Cup, Hwang of Korea was in the final eight, and he's not even here. They're a very deep country, deep saber country, no question about it.
Dershowitz.
Dershowitz there made the attack in preparation.
Gooseherst hesitated a little bit, stopped, and he was a little disappointed. He's appealing to the ref, and body language says he wasn't quite ready for that call. Attack scores by Goo, long lunge.
Dershowitz acknowledges.
The referee says simultaneous. And reprise of attack by Goo, one lighter, just chased him down and hit him.
If you heard that clunk of steel, it's because Dershowitz made the parry but dismissed on the riposte.
The attack and Dershowitz wants the pair of post.
Right. There's a blade action. You can hear it. It's up to the referee to determine who earned it, who started it.
Mr. Kosha of Hungary goes behind and says it was Dershowitz's. To all. A lot of noise in the room.
No question about that one.
Pair of riposte. Dershowitz scores. Pushing him down, pushing him down. Oh, and beat attack. That was something.
Lightning fast by Dershowitz there. Just a quick beat on the blade and a thrust. Referee says attack by Goo. Dershowitz says, didn't he hit my guard, which would constitute a parry? And can you please, I'm challenging this, and please take a look.
The yellow strip, Curatoli of Italy, ahead 5-2 of the Korean O.
Referee sticks with the call. Goo makes it 3-4.
That gives Dershowitz the attack. There was blade contact there.
I think it was second intention by Dershowitz. He waited for Goo's attack, made the parry in the riposte, and that's what the referee called.
But Dershowitz short, and Goo takes over. When you drop your weapon, you really can't defend yourself.
Very difficult. If there's an immediate attack underway, it counts. Otherwise, the referee would call halt and the fencer was disarmed.
Very close bouts on all the other pieces.
Here comes Dershowitz pushing and scoring.
I thought he stopped and then restarted.
He did.
Meanwhile, on the yellow piece, Kuratoli goes into the break ahead 8-4. Against O of Korea.
You see, everyone's starting quickly here on the referee before the referee's command of fence or alley, and Goob points back and says they hear my other fencer yelling, so it's distracting.
Just short, but the repost is also short. Just pushing, pushing, pushing. And he gives the beat attack and not the pair of repost, as you have always pointed out. If there's one sound, the attacker gets the priority.
And Goo tried to parry at the same time, but if it's at the same time, it goes to the person who initiated it, and that was Dershowitz. That action simultaneous.
Well, that was parry repost, my goodness. And Dershowitz thought he hit, he wants a test. Nope.
Beautiful pulling of distance or getting out of the way for Goo. Makes it a nice riposte. Dershowitz with an attack in preparation and goes to the break up 8-6.
Meanwhile, the blue strip. Hungarian ahead. Satmari over Apiti of France, A5, and they're going back in the competition. Coratoli continues to lead, 9-7 on the yellow piece. And over on the green piece, going into the break, an 8-7 advantage.
So during this one-minute break, the fencers get a chance to get a drink, towel off, get some coaching, and basically just take a rest.
And the green piece, Szilagyi ahead by one touch over Kim of Korea, Szilagyi of Hungary. And now we're ready to resume here on the red piece with Dershowitz ahead, 8-6, into the second half of the bout. And he gives the Prix de Fer, or he taking of the blade to Dershowitz after his attack was short.
Gu motioning to his guard, saying, didn't his blade land on my guard? If it did, according to the rules of Sabre, it would constitute a parry. And that's what he's asking for. And the referee says, no, it's beat attack from Dershowitz. Many of these actions are so close. Even on replay, they're very difficult.
You can sometimes tell by the sound also. It sounded like it was up in the middle of the blade to me. I think it was... That's what he ruled.
It's a distinct clunk when you hit the guard. I agree with you. I didn't hear that clunk.
So the attack was clean and unimpeded by Gu, and he scores on the attack.
It's almost like Dershowitz took a mental timeout in that touch. He really didn't retreat or defend.
Yeah. Oh, Prix de Fer again. For me.
Referee Kosha is looking.
He wasn't sure.
Based on Dershowitz's reaction, he thinks that there were two beats, and he took the second one, which would mean a parry. But let's see what the referee says.
Meanwhile, in the yellow piece, Mo has certainly caught up. He's only behind by one touch, 8-9. Some kind of medical attention to him.
Referee Kosha has made his decision, and here it is. And he's bringing the fencers down, saying, no touch. Dershowitz so disappointed. He felt he had earned it. When you take lessons and practice and execute, and you think it was yours, it's so frustrating. That doesn't mean it was his, but he seems pretty frustrated anyway.
So, here's the beat attack. That time he got a clean parry. Clunk, clunk, as you say.
If the ref's not giving you those little close ones, make it certainly blatant, and that was blatant. Wow, Dershowitz quick off the mark as Gu is starting to attack, but not quite commencing with the arm, just the feet. Dershowitz saw a little opening and just exploded with a straight attack with a lunge.
And Gu walked back, tried to gather himself. I think he glanced at his coach, took off his mask. Getting ready. He really knows he has to come back here. Up against a tough opponent. And pair riposte by Gu.
Dershowitz again going for the replay. This will be his second and final one if he loses this challenge. Very early in the bout. Quick decision by the referee, which is usually not a good sign when you challenge, and it's not for Dershowitz. And he's going to tell him that he's out of... No more challenges for Dershowitz. No. He says, don't I have one? No, he didn't, because he lost both so far.
Meanwhile, on the blue piece. The Frenchman ahead. IPT leading Satmari. 10-6. Ooh, short riposte and reprise of attack.
Gu stopped. He made a quick riposte that was short, no light, and he stopped. And the fencer's not supposed to do that. It's not fair to the opponent.
He's very frustrated. He was sure he hit. He ripped off his mask. Now he just made a couple of tests. They worked. It was proven wrong electronically, but he's still not satisfied.
It wasn't bad sportsmanship. It wasn't like he was trying to gain an advantage, but he did stop. And you're not supposed to stop fencing until the referee says halt. simultaneous.
That was a parry river. That long attack was parried, and that was very clear also.
Dershowitz didn't quite set that one up, a little bit out of distance, and Gu was able to retreat, see the attack, make the parry in the riposte.
Gu pulls distance and regains the attack to tie it up.
I heard some blade contact there, but the referee said that Dershowitz's attack was no, it missed.
Gu takes over and makes the attack, and now he's gone ahead, 12-11.
Dershowitz needs to regroup here. Three quick ones. Dershowitz was in trouble there. He ceded ground. He retreated sort of passively, allowed Gu to set up the attack.
That's unusual. His body language is different now, talking about Dershowitz. And Gu is ahead again.
And Dershowitz is shorthanded here because he has no more challenges left. So even theoretically, if the referee makes a mistake, he's not allowed to challenge it.
Meanwhile, it's 13 all over on the green feast. Between Kim of Korea and Szilagyi of Hungary.
And there it is, Gu with the long attack.
Number one in the world has eliminated the young Turk.
There was a big change of momentum there in the last third of the bout, and everything Gu did worked, and nothing Dershowitz did was able to stop it.
That was impressive. What a comeback. Dershowitz had a great lead. It didn't work. And now he's still appealing to the ref. Meanwhile, on the green piece, Szilagyi ahead 14-13.
Szilagyi, the two-time defending Olympic gold medalist. And into the top four goes Szilagyi.
So, Mr. Gu of Korea survives. And Mr. Oh does not. Wait, I'm wrong about that.
Kuratulian. Oh, here we are.
11-11.
11-11.
It's Mr. Kim who's been eliminated.
Seems like every bout Kuratoli's in is a real battle.
Oh, he stopped. Yeah. Oh, great run today.
And a great attack there.
And another great attack. But Kuratoli does not agree.
Oh started. Kuratoli tried to get a simultaneous out of that, but he was just a little bit too slow. But he's challenging the call. Referee Malanchev says, I'm sticking with it, 13-11.
Parry riposte.
And Kuratoli says, his parry was low on my guard. If it's on the lower third of the blade or the guard.
He was correct.
And he's correct, and he gets it. And you can see the... Now, isn't that interesting? After the referee changed the call, O is now challenging it. Does he really think that the referee, after reviewing the video and changing his call, is now going to change it back?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
Why did he do that? It was a waste of a challenge.
I think so.
Gives the attack to O. 14-12, O ahead. And victory, O, on the reprise of attack, 15-12, two Koreans in the top four.
Explosive.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, now we're about to move on to the top four, the semifinals in this round. The losers each receive bronze medals, and the winners fence off for the gold medal. So we're going to take a break and sum up. Get ready for the semifinals. Peter Bouchard of the FIE Fencing Channel, along with my esteemed colleague, Jeff Bukant. We'll be right back.